This is an introduction video to the poem The Wasteland. It's really important to know all these poems before you move into the sections. T.S. Eliot's masterpiece The Wasteland was published in 1922. This is the same year when Tennyson's Ulysses was published. Poem The Wasteland is considered to be the central work of modernist literature. It is written in free verse and is 433 lines long. When Eliot wrote this poem, it was double this size, but later on his friend Ezra Pound edited this poem into 433 lines. The poem is also dedicated to Ezra Pound. The Wasteland first appeared in the magazine The Criterion. If we talk about the structure of the poem, The Wasteland consists of 5 sections: The Burial of the Dead, A Game of Chess, The Fire Sermon, Death by Water, and What the Thunder Said. The title is taken from Saint Augustine's Confessions. There is a line, "I wandered, O my God, too much astray from thee. My stay in these days of my youth, and I became to myself a wasteland." So it is from this line that the title of the poem has been taken. Wasteland is not a geographical area, it represents the mind of the modern man. Now let's see the epigraph of the poem. Now, the actual epigraph that Eliot had intended was from Heart of Darkness by Joseph Conrad. The epigraph was The Horror, The Horror. But his friend Ezra Pound suggested otherwise, because of which Eliot changed the epigraph. The given lines in red is the actual epigraph of Wasteland. This is the story of Sibyl from Satyren by Petronius. The story of Sibyl goes like this. Sibyl wanted to live a very long life. So she asked God Apollo for her long life, but she didn't ask for long youth. So her wish was granted, but only half of her wish. And thus, her body started to shrink that she was put in a jar. And once a boy asks Sibyl, what does she want? And she finally says, I want to die. And these are the lines. For once I myself saw with my own eyes the Sibyl at Cumae hanging in a cage. And when the boy said to her, Sibyl, what do you want? She replied, I want to die. The epigraph is really important in the poem because it portrays the theme of the whole poem. The Sibyl state of languish, where she is living but she is also dead at the same time. This misfortune of hers is the motive of Wasteland. That is, life has lost all its charm and only death can be a warm welcome. You will understand why this epigraph is important once we move into the poem. The poem is dedicated to Ezra Pound, whom Eliot calls the better craftsman. Eliot was inspired mainly by 2 books when he wrote this poem. One is Jesse Weston's From Ritual to Romance and the other one is Sir James Fraser's The Golden Bow. In The Golden Bow, Sir James Fraser talks about how ceremonies were performed in order to ensure the return of gods and thus ensure the return of fertility. Jesse Weston in From Ritual to Romance shows that these ancient myths and ceremonies have continued even after the arrival of Christianity, but in a very different form. An example is the legend of the Holy Grail. Holy Grail is the cup used by Christ at his Last Supper with his disciples. Now, this Holy Grail is associated with the myth of the Fisher King. This Fisher King story is an Arthurian legend. According to this story, it is the duty of the Fisher King to safeguard this Holy Grail. This Fisher King is always wounded, so all he could do is catch fish for his kingdom. Once in his kingdom, there was grail worship, but because of the sins of his knights and the people in his kingdom, the grail worship was abandoned and as a result, their land became barren. So in order to heal the king and in order to bring life-giving rains to their land, a knight with a pure soul should go to the chapel Perilous and answer some riddles. Finally, a knight with a pure soul named Knight Percival goes to the chapel Perilous and answer all the questions and riddles, and this results in life-giving rain in their land. The king is also healed. You should also know why this myth is important when we study the poem The Wasteland. Just as how the knight of this tale is in a quest for life-giving rains, the same way we find that in the poem there is a quest, but it is not simply for the rains, but rain is a metaphor here for spirituality. Because at the time when this poem was written, Eliot was witnessing all the world wars and cruelties of the modern world. The post-war atmosphere and the lack of spirituality is very evident in the poem. Before you move into the other parts of the poem, please remember that this poem is written in fragments. You may not understand the meaning of the poem in the very first reading, but it will all make sense to you by the time we discuss the last part of the poem. So follow the links to the line-by-line analysis of all the 5 sections of Wasteland. It is given in the description below. You can freely add any more information that you know about Wasteland down in the comment section. And if you have found this video useful, don't forget to subscribe to get more of my videos. Thanks so much for watching.